Hello, Lakers Nation. Sean Davis here for LakersNation.com, your home for everything Lakers. The Lakers got some big injury updates for a few key players on the roster. I'm going to break it all down for you. Before I get into all of that, a quick reminder, guys, please do subscribe right here to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel. Ring that post notification bell as well as the easiest way for you all to stay in the know with our Lakers coverage. It's going to be a ton of fun breaking down everything Lakers related for you all this season. You're going to want to stay in the know to our Lakers content. And make sure you guys are subscribing over on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, wherever you listen to our podcast, to the LakersNation.com podcast. And give ourselves a 5-star rating and review is the easiest way to help out the podcast. You can take us wherever you go, on the way to work, on the way to the gym, wherever, and go check out the LakersNation.com podcast. Now let's dive into it. Darvin Ham announces today that Dennis Schroeder has successful surgery on his injured thumb. He's expected to miss 3 to 4 weeks with his thumb injury. Honestly, this is probably the best worst case scenario news possible. He's always expected to miss 3 to 4 weeks, although some thumb injuries in the past, like Taylor Horn Tucker's even and Chris Paul's, have lingered to as much as 6 weeks. So that is, you know, maybe some optimism from Coach Ham that it's only going to be 3 to 4 weeks. And so you could see Dennis Schroeder potentially back in the Lakers uniform from early to mid-November. So that is good to hear from Coach Darvin Ham. We also get an update on Russell Westbrook. Russell Westbrook, he is still dealing with the hamstring injury. And there is no structural damage. And he is listed as day-to-day and actually a game-time decision, reportedly, for tomorrow night's contest against the Golden State Warriors in Golden State for opening night. Again, best-case scenario for Russell Westbrook. Hamstring injuries are really, really tricky to handle and deal with. So you want to make sure you're playing this as safely as you possibly can. You don't want to make sure that this injury lingers, long term. That's basically best case. And it's good to hear that Russell Westbrook is fine. There's no big damage there. Also, Troy Brown Jr., it's more of a day-to-day situation. He continues to make progress in practice. These are three key guys. And the reason I say key, because our guys are going to likely play in the rotation. We know Russ is. You have to imagine with the lack of wings on the roster, Troy Brown Jr. is going to be a part of this rotation as well. So the sooner we get to see these guys back in the frame, the better. And, you know, maybe, and this is a crazy, but maybe now Max Christie has to play tonight. But that's not ideal. So the sooner Troy Brown can get back, the better, because now that's one extra spot fill. Now you have an extra wing on the roster, because now you would have Troy Brown, JTA, Max, LeBron, AD will probably play some four spot, et cetera, et cetera. So this is good news. All in all, I think this is some positive news given the situations involving Russell Westbrook, Dennis Schroeder, and Troy Brown Jr. So this is good to hear that all the guys are making progress. Dennis has successful surgery, and Russ and Troy Brown, like I said, day-to-day, and Troy Brown is making good progress in practice. Last reminder before we get you guys out of here, guys, make sure you guys come back tonight to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel for the first Scouting Report breakdown live show on the channel, Lakers Nation Scouting Show. It'll be on the channel tonight, 10 o'clock Eastern time, 7 p.m. Pacific. Make sure you guys stick around. We'll have a ton of fun. Till next, everybody. See ya, and stay safe.